Good day, everybody. My name is Tesola Yorunaga, and we're here to discuss a topic called female genital mutilation. This is a topic that has been brought up with many controversial opinions. But before we go into it, I'm going to let my panelists introduce themselves.
I'm Daniel Tsukudo.
I'm David Fair.
Yashaya Kubu.
Similar in general.
David Spoli.
Okay, now that we have gotten to know our panelists, I'm going to go straight into the topic. Now, what exactly is female genital mutilation?
Female genital mutilation, also known as female circumcision, is the cutting of the foreskin of female genitalia.
Okay, now that we've gotten the definition, what in your own opinion, and like, where does it really come into play? Which group of people does it affect the most?
For me, it's mostly the illiterates that are affected, because based on their ideologies, they do not understand the effects of these things. They feel it's good and it shows a sign of womanhood in some places. Why I say mostly was because it can't be 100% for some. The little percentage that are literate that still do it are, let's say, like women who come from families that they have been doing it for a long time. It doesn't mean that they are necessarily illiterate. So they end up being forced into it.
Thank you, Daniel, for that brief explanation. You know, now I've gotten the reasons. Now I've gotten like where it is most affected. Now we get to the reason. What drives them to do this? What makes them go ahead?
In my own opinion, a reason is cultural beliefs. Because in some families, it's been passed down. Female genital circumcision, as they call it, has been passed down from generation to generation. So they see it as something that is natural for them to do.
Also, another reason people get circumcised is the fear of being stigmatized. In some traditions, people stigmatize females who have not undergone this harmful circumcision that is done to them, and in some cases to men might not want to marry women who have not been circumcised because they don't see them as people, so they might want to undergo the circumcision. This belief is therefore not practical.
Okay, thank you, Timmy and Yesha. And then in our opinion on the subject matter.
To add to what they have said, I think religion is also a factor. In Nigeria we practice mostly two religions, which are Christianity and Islam. And also, I also feel that illiteracy is a factor, because some people are still not aware of these things. So I feel that's my opinion.
Thank you, Daniel.
But
based on these reasons that I've already given, is the practice justified? Does it give them enough reason to continue?
Action.
On the religion aspect I mentioned earlier, the Christianity and Islam, there's nowhere stated in either the Bible or the Quran that states that circumcision should be practiced on women. I only know of there being a place, a part of the Bible where you're meant to circumcise the men for some purity reasons.
Obviously, no, it can't be justified. The part that was said about people thinking that women will be promiscuous, obviously, that's why Daniel said earlier that it's uneducated people that practice these times. Because if they were educated, they knew that it's not the clitoris that's responsible for the sexual urges. It's their hormones that are responsible for that. And then hormones are excreted by the ovaries or in men, the testes. That's estrogen and testosterone. So then they can't say that it's clitoris that prevents, that makes them promiscuous, because obviously it's sexually driven.
Okay, now that we've established the reasons and whether they're justifiable or not, what are the ways in which people carry out female genital mutilation?
There are different types of female genital mutilation. Type 1, this is the cutting or the removal of the clitoris of the female. This is also known as clitoridectomy. And then this type, less pain is born.
And also type 2, which is also called excision. is the removal of the labial minora and in some cases the labial majora, the woman genital.
And also type 3 or E fibrillation. Here the labia minora, labia majora, clitoris are cut off, then genitalia is sewed up, leaving a small hole for urine and other discharge. And sometimes two legs are being tied up for 6 weeks so that the genitalia can be removed.
Well, those are some very disturbing ways in which the practice is carried out. But then what are the implications, the repercussions of these women?
The implications of female genital mutilation can lead to scars and keratitis and lack of sexual pleasure. That's the vesico vaginal fistula, that's when the female is not able to control her urine, she not carries and buckets everywhere to enable her urine.
Okay, now that we know the implications and the consequences of this female genital mutilation, how do you think we can tell these people to stop what they're doing? How can we eradicate this female genital mutilation and end it at once? Well, I personally believe that education is key. If these women, these mothers were educated like we are, they won't be doing such a harmful act practice. So I believe that they should be educated.
My advice to the people is that they should public awareness of the dangers, mostly in the rural areas, so that the women and female, let me say female in general, know the implication of the female genital mutilation.
In my opinion, the way female genital mutilation can be stopped is if there is a sanction, preferable to the effect. If there is a sanction, people will be cautious about doing this helpful practice to young girls and then to be in turn stopped, hopefully.
Adding to what David said about public enlightenment, I feel that since these people are in rural areas and most of them are illiterate, I feel that the people who should be enlightening them as a public should be people who know how to speak their own language, not necessarily being like actual language, but who talk like them and relate like them so that they can understand better.
Thank you, Daniel, for that summation of everything that we have discussed. I hope that everybody has learned so much more on human genital mutilation and everybody has been to fight against it so we can help these young ladies in all these rural areas.